गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ अलजेब्रा स्टैंडर्ड 9. दिस इज रियल नंबर्स. नाउ फर्स्ट वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हिच आर कॉल्ड एज रियल नंबर्स. व्हाट इज मीन बाय रियल नंबर्स? सो फॉर दैट वी हैव टू सी डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ नंबर्स व्हिच वी हैव सीन इन प्रीवियस लेसन ऑल्सो. सो टुडे अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज देम. फर्स्ट इज सेट ऑफ नेचुरल नंबर्स. And natural numbers set is started from 1. So these are 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So these are the numbers from set of natural numbers. And these are started from 1 only. 0 is not present here. Why 0 is not present here? Because in set of the set of natural numbers is called as the set of counting numbers. Then second set we have seen in previous lesson, that is set of whole numbers. Set of whole numbers started from 0 and 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Why 0 is present in set of whole numbers? Because these are writing numbers. Then third set is set of integers. Set of integers contains negative numbers, positive numbers and 0. Again, infinite numbers are present in the set of integers. In all sets, infinite numbers are present. Then fourth set is set of rational numbers. So what is meant by rational number? We have seen in previous lesson definition of rational numbers. The numbers which are written in the form of P upon Q are called as rational numbers, where Q does not belongs to 0 or Q is not equal to 0. So these are set of rational numbers. Then next set is set of irrational numbers. So what is meant by irrational number set? The numbers which are in the form of square root or cube root or fourth root of such kind. So these are the elements of set of irrational numbers. So in previous lesson we have seen here root 3, root 2, then minus root 2 also. So such root 5. So these are not in order. Just we have written here which kinds of numbers are called as irrational numbers. So these kinds of numbers are called as irrational numbers. So in previous lesson we have seen in detail what is meant by rational number and what is meant by irrational number. So rational number's definition is the numbers which are in the form of P upon Q and Q must not be equal to 0. These kinds of numbers are called as rational numbers. This is first definition of rational numbers. And what is second definition of rational numbers? It is very important for you to understand what is meant by rational numbers. So second definition for rational numbers is the numbers in the form of P upon Q, but after finding out their division, so that P divided by Q, here the quotient obtained should be recurring. And the division should be terminating or non-terminating. So if division is non-terminating means unending division, remainder should not be equal to 0. So that is called as non-terminating or unending division. So the quotient is recurring and the division is non-terminating, then those numbers are also called as rational numbers. So these are two important definitions for rational numbers. In previous lesson we have seen it. And what is meant by irrational number? That is also very important to understand what is meant by irrational numbers. So irrational numbers means if we are going to find out the value of root 2. So the method to find out value of root 2 here we will find out. So the method is given in your textbook also, and example is given solved there how to find out square root of 2. So this is the method. Now here we have to take one such number, and same number we have to take in quotient, and multiplication of these two numbers, 1 into 1 it is 1, and subtract it, so 2 minus 1 is 1. Now next step is very important here. 1 plus 1. Which quotient you have written here, that number you have to add here again. Now 1 plus 1 is 2. Again point is there, so you have to take point here again and take these two zeros. Group of numbers you have to take here. So 100 is there. Now you have to take here such number. So and same number you have to take in quotient and multiplication of 24 and 4 should be subtracted from the number here. Which is the number here? You have to subtract multiplication of these two numbers. So what is multiplication of these two numbers? It is 96. It can be subtracted from 100. Remainder is 4. Again, what we have to do? This quotient, only 4, we have to add here. And 24 plus 4, that is 28. So this is the method. And same method we have to apply here in next steps also. Again, here two zeros we have to take down. And now we have to choose here such number so that multiplication of these two numbers should be subtracted from the number here. Now 281 multiplied by 1 is 281. Now subtract here. So here 9, 1 and here again 1. And again this number we have to add here. So I think you understood what is the method of finding out square root. For any number you have to apply same method. Now again in next step you have to take here group of numbers, that is two zeros. Again you have to choose here one such number so that multiplication of these two numbers should be subtracted from the number here. So suppose we have written here 4. So whatever number you have chosen, you have to write here and in quotient also, same number. Again multiplication of these two numbers should be subtracted here, and subtraction you have to write there, subtraction here. So in this way, this is the method of finding out value of square root of 2. And if you will try to find out the value of square root of 2 here, the division is unending, means it is non-terminating. So what is meant by non-terminating division? The zero is not occur in the division. There will be no zero in the remainder. Remainder side mein zero nahi aayega. So that is called as non-terminating division. And the quotient should be non-recurring. So what is the condition for set of irrational number? So quotient should be non-recurring. Important condition is there. Quotient should be non-recurring and remainder should not equal to zero, or remainder is non-terminating. So these two words you have to keep in mind and try to understand their meaning also. What is meant by non-recurring quotient? Non-recurring quotient means no two numbers are repeated in the same order, or no numbers are repeated in the same order. In some of the divisions, the numbers are repeated in the same order. We will see here. Here we will see. See here. If we are going to find out value of 2 divided by 3. So 2 divided by 3. So 3 zeros are 0. Now 3 6s are 18. Again 2 is there. Then 3 6s are 18. 3 6s are 18. So observe carefully. What is the remainder? Remainder is non-zero. Means division is non-terminating. And what is the quotient? Quotient is 0.666. And again, if we will continue to divide it, then we will get 6666 again. So 6 is repeating here. What is repeating here? 6 is repeating. So if quotient is repeating, then it is called as recurring. So quotient is recurring and division is non-terminating. So if quotient is recurring and division is non-terminating, then those numbers are called as rational numbers. We have seen two definitions of rational numbers. And what is meant by irrational number? Irrational number means no number is repeating here again and again in the same order. So it is called as non-recurring. and division is also unending, so it is non-terminating also. So the difference between rational numbers and irrational numbers is, in rational numbers the quotient is recurring and non-terminating. In rational numbers quotient is recurring and non-terminating, and in irrational numbers the quotient is non-recurring and non-terminating. So this is the difference between rational numbers and irrational numbers. So I think it is clear to you. And then last one is, what is meant by real numbers? This is our lesson and it is very important to understand what is meant by real numbers. So real number means the numbers from all the above sets are the elements of set of real numbers. So all the above sets numbers means all natural numbers, all whole numbers, all integers, all rational numbers and all irrational numbers, all are the elements of set of real numbers. So I think you understood what is meant by real numbers. Then how to find out square root of different numbers? This is very important method to you, and I think you understood it, and try to practice it again, taking square root of 3, square root of 5, and by same method you can find out it. Then next, here next topic in real numbers lesson is order relation on rational numbers. So we have seen what is meant by rational numbers. Rational numbers means the numbers which are written in P by Q form. So if we have taken two types of rational numbers here, suppose first rational number is P upon Q and second rational number is R upon S. So P by Q and R by S, these are two rational numbers, and here Q and S should not, or Q should not equal to 0 and R should not equal to 0, sorry S. So this is the important condition here. Q should not be equal to 0, S should not be equal to 0. Such two rational numbers are here and we have to find out its order relation. So order relation means which rational number is greater, which rational number is smaller, and if they are equal. Rational number is smaller or greater or equal, this we have to find here, and that is called as order relation on rational numbers. So two rational numbers we have taken here, and suppose if first condition we will see here, if P upon Q is equal to R upon S, this is the condition. If two rational numbers are equal, then cross multiply here, PS is equal to QR. If two rational numbers are equal, then what is the relation between the numbers here? Cross multiply, PS is equal to QR. Then second condition here, if P upon Q is less than R upon S, then agar first rational number second rational number se smaller hai, to phir kya likh sakte hai hum yahan par is condition aise type mein kya likh sakte hai? So again we have to multiply here, cross multiply PS, and less than hai, to here less than, PS is less than QR. This is second order relation. And third one is, if first rational number is greater than second rational number, means P by Q is greater than R by S, then what we can write here? Again cross multiply, PS is greater than QR. So these are three important order relations here in upon rational numbers. So I think clear, P by Q is equal to R by S, P by Q is less than R by S, and third one is P by Q is greater than R by S. So keep in mind. Then next important property of rational numbers is here, properties of rational numbers. So here properties are given, and which are the properties? Commutative property, associative property, identity and inverse. These are four important properties on all numbers. In previous standards, we have seen them on natural numbers, on whole numbers. So these properties are very well known to you. So first is commutative property. So what is meant by commutative property? Here, suppose A is first rational number and B is second rational number, then A plus B is equal to B plus A. Means first rational number में second rational number add करेंगे तो उसका जो answer आएगा वही answer second rational number में first rational number add करेंगे तो वही answer आएगा, same answer आएगा. So that is called as commutative property and it is valid upon multiplication also. So अगर first rational number second rational number से multiply करेंगे तो जो answer आएगा same answer आएगा अगर second rational number first rational number से multiply करते हैं तो. So this is called as commutative property. अब आप बोलेंगे A और B ये जो numbers लिए हैं ये यहाँ rational numbers के जैसे नहीं दिखते हैं. So rational numbers means ये form में जो numbers रहते हैं those are called as rational numbers. So let's try here. We will take some numbers and then we will verify commutative property upon those rational numbers. So let us take simple rational numbers. First rational number is 1 by 2 and second rational number is 3 by 4. ऐसे दो rational numbers लिए हैं. हम अभी इनको ये first commutative property इस पर हम verify करके देखेंगे. So what is commutative property of addition here? Let's see. 1 by 2 plus 3 by 4. So what is its answer? So denominator are different, therefore we will solve by cross multiplication or by LCM method. There are many methods. So by any method you can solve. So let's try with cross multiplication. 4 1s are 4 plus 2 3s are 6 and 2 4s are 8. Now 4 plus 6 is 10 upon 8 and we can find out its least form also. So it is 5 by 4. So answer of addition of both rational numbers is equal to 5 by 4. इन दिस ऑर्डर अब फर्स्ट रैशनल नंबर में सेकंड रैशनल नंबर ऐड किया तो 5 बाय 4 आंसर आया. नाउ वी विल फाइंड आउट सेकंड रैशनल नंबर में फर्स्ट रैशनल नंबर ऐड करेंगे तो क्या आंसर आता है. सो अगेन क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई 3 2 आर 6 प्लस 4 1 आर 4 एंड 4 2 आर 8. सो इट इज 10 अपॉन 8 एंड अगेन इट्स लीस्ट फॉर्म इज 5 बाय 4. सो सेम आंसर वी विल गॉट हियर एंड same come here we have written in a b form. सिर्फ यहाँ पर हमने rational numbers की जगह a और b consider किए हैं, generalized form किया है उस लिया है उसका general form and यहाँ आप special numbers लेकर भी वो property जो है उसको verify करके देख सकते हैं. so 1 by 2 plus 3 by 4 answer is 5 by 4. अगर 3 by 4 में 1 by 2 add किया तो भी same answer ही मिलता है. this is called as commutative property. Then second property is associative property. अभी three numbers हैं a plus b plus c. उसमें a plus b में अगर third number add किया और यहाँ हमने association उसका यानी groupism जो है वो change कर दिया तो क्या फर्क पड़ता है. अभी मैंने directly लिख दिया है यहाँ पर कि दोनों equal ही रहते हैं. अब यहाँ हम check करेंगे इसके जैसे. अब यहाँ three rational numbers लेने हैं हमको 1 by 2, 3 by 4 और simple 1 by 3 एक ले लेते हैं. अब एडिशन करके देखेंगे यहाँ डायरेक्ट नंबर लेकर या इसमें अभी हम मल्टीप्लिकेशन में उसको वेरीफाई करेंगे. ए मल्टीप्लाई बाय बी मल्टीप्लाई बाय सी इज इक्वल टू ए मल्टीप्लाई बाय बी मल्टीप्लाई बाय सी. सो अगर फर्स्ट रैशनल नंबर में सेकंड रैशनल नंबर ऐड किया और दोनों के एडिशन में बाद में फिर हमने थर्ड रैशनल नंबर ऐड किया तो जो आंसर आता है सेम आंसर पहले सेकंड और थर्ड रैशनल नंबर की एडिशन करेंगे और उसमें फर्स्ट रैशनल नंबर ऐड करेंगे तो सेम आंसर आएगा. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी एंड एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी अपॉन मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑपरेशन भी क्या होता है. अगर फर्स्ट रैशनल नंबर और सेकंड रैशनल नंबर का मल्टीप्लीकेशन करेंगे और बाद में उसको थर्ड रैशनल नंबर से मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे तो जो आंसर आएगा वैसे ही सेम आंसर अगर हम सेकंड और थर्ड रैशनल नंबर को पहले मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे एंड आफ्टर वी विल मल्टीप्लाई बोथ ऑफ देम बाय फर्स्ट रैशनल नंबर द सेम आंसर वी विल गेट हियर एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड एज multiplication, the associative property over multiplication, associative property of rational numbers over multiplication. So यहाँ हम multiplication के लिए verify करके देखेंगे associative property. So 1 by 2 multiply by 3 by 4 multiply by 1 by 3. So first we will solve bracket. So 3 1s are 3 multiplication है. 3 1s are 3, 4 2s are 8 multiply by 1 by 3 and again multiplication है. So 3 1s are 3 and 8 3s are 24 and least form 1 upon 8. So ये आया अपना left hand side का answer in multiplication form में. And राइट हैंड साइड क्या है कि फर्स्ट नंबर से हम बाद में मल्टीप्लाई करने वाले हैं, सेकंड और थर्ड नंबर का मल्टीप्लिकेशन पहले कर लेंगे. सो फर्स्ट वी विल सॉल्व ब्रैकेट हियर. अगेन मल्टीप्लिकेशन है, 3 1s are 3 एंड 4 3s are 12. अब ये आ गया दोनों नंबर्स का मल्टीप्लिकेशन. आफ्टर दैट वी विल मल्टीप्लाई हियर, 3 1s are 3 एंड 12 2s are 24 एंड लीस्ट फॉर्म है उसका 1 upon 8. सो दोनों लेफ्ट हैंड साइड का आंसर जो आया वही राइट हैंड साइड का आंसर आया है. मींस एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी क्या है कि थ्री नंबर्स अगर है आपके पास रैशनल नंबर्स, उसमें फर्स्ट टू नंबर्स का ग्रुप लिया और बाद में उसमें थर्ड रैशनल नंबर ऐड किया, फर्स्ट टू ग्रुप का एडिशन कंप्लीट होने के बाद थर्ड नंबर ऐड किया, तो जो आंसर आता है सेम आंसर लास्ट टू नंबर्स को पहले ऐड करके बाद में उसमें फर्स्ट नंबर ऐड करेंगे तो सेम ही आंसर आएगा. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी. एसोसिएशन मीन्स ग्रुप करना है. यहाँ पर फर्स्ट टू रैशनल नंबर्स का ग्रुप किया, यहाँ पर लास्ट टू रैशनल नंबर्स का ग्रुप किया, इन दिस वे. देन नेक्स्ट है आइडेंटिटी ऑपरेशन. सो आइडेंटिटी ओवर एडिशन. सो आइडेंटिटी एडिटिव आइडेंटिटी कौन सी है, तो अगर कोई भी रैशनल नंबर में जीरो ऐड करेंगे तो सेम आंसर आता है. तो जीरो इज कॉल्ड एज एडिटिव आइडेंटिटी. So a plus 0 is equal to 0 plus a and answer will be the same number, same rational number. एक rational number लिया उसमें 0 add किया तो वही rational number उसका answer आएगा. So that is called as additive identity of rational number. And what is meant by multiplicative identity? So कौन से number से हम एक rational number को multiply करेंगे तो same answer आएगा 1 से. सबको पता है कि 1 से अगर कोई भी number को multiply करते हैं तो answer वही number आता है. So a multiply by 1 is equal to 1 multiply by a is equal to a. Same answer आएगा. So 0 is called as additive identity and 1 is called as multiplicative identity. So keep in mind it is very important. Then additive inverse. Additive inverse means क्या कि एक rational number लिया हमने, उसमें हम कौन सा number add करेंगे तो answer 0 आएगा. So a में क्या ऐड करेंगे तो आंसर 0 आएगा. इसके लिए हम एक नंबर ही लेकर देखते हैं. यहाँ पर सपोज 2 बाई 3 है एक रैशनल नंबर, उसमें हम कौन सा नंबर ऐड करेंगे तो हमको 0 आंसर मिलेगा. सो 2 बाई 3 में माइनस 2 बाई 3 ऐड करेंगे. 2 बाई 3 प्लस माइनस 2 बाई 3 इज इक्वल टू 0. सो जो नंबर है रैशनल नंबर उसका एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट नंबर, हम साइन से अपोजिट नंबर अगर हम लेते हैं, जैसे a है तो माइनस ए, ए प्लस माइनस ए इज इक्वल टू 0. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज एडिटिव इनवर्स. और मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इनवर्स किसको बोलते हैं, वन आंसर आना चाहिए. ए में ए को कौन से नंबर से हम मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे तो आंसर 1 आएगा. सो यहाँ पर और हम एक रैशनल नंबर लेकर देखते हैं, 2 बाई 3 सेम, और कौन से नंबर से हम इसको मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे तो 1 आंसर आएगा. इसका इनवर्स लेना है. So it is 2 by 3 का inverse क्या आएगा, 3 by 2. So this is called as multiplicative inverse. So यहाँ पर आएगा a का multiplicative inverse है 1 upon a. a multiply by 1 upon a is equal to 1. So these are the properties upon rational numbers. So क्या क्या देखा हमने अभी ये lesson में, कि second lesson है अपना real numbers. So real numbers किसको बोलते हैं, तो ये sets में आने वाले सारे numbers जो है वो रियल नंबर्स में आते हैं. सेकंड क्या देखा, ऑर्डर रिलेशन ऑन रियल नंबर्स. सो ऑर्डर रिलेशन हमने देखा था टू रैशनल नंबर्स, ऑर्डर रिलेशन ऑन रैशनल नंबर्स देखा था, नॉट रियल नंबर्स. सो क्या देखा था, उसमें टू रैशनल नंबर्स लिए थे और उसमें कौन से दो रैशनल नंबर्स इक्वल है, कौन सा ग्रेटर है, कौन सा लेस है, और उसके बाद में उसकी अगर इक्वल है तो क्या कंडीशन आती है, लेस है तो क्या कंडीशन आती है, ग्रेटर है तो क्या कंडीशन आती है, ये इसके पहले हमने लिखा था. एंड आफ्टर दैट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स हमने देखे. सो प्रॉपर्टीज कौन से हैं रैशनल नंबर्स के, कम्यूटेटिव, एसोसिएटिव, आइडेंटिटी एंड इनवर्स, और ये सब हमने देखे हैं एडिशन के ऊपर एंड मल्टीप्लीकेशन के ऊपर.